Thank you for joining us for your coronavirus HQ update. I'm Jordan Fremstead. For the first time since 1989, the WIAA State Track and Field Championships are not being held in La Crosse. Today was set to be the first of 2 days of the meet, which brings tens of thousands of people to Veterans Memorial Field Sports Complex. It's estimated that the event brings at least $2.5 million to the local economy, and that impact echoes throughout the year from those normally filling the stands.
They talk and we hear the participants, we hear their families say, I had no idea this was over. I had no idea how beautiful it was here. We've got to come back.
When they were in the stands, those fans would be throughout our area, staying in hotels and eating at restaurants. Gary Rudy at Rudy's Drive-In says the weekend would usually double the restaurant's business.
We've got quite a following of the schools that come here after they're done. And they sit on the picnic tables and, you know, just have a good time. So they're certainly going to be missed.
About 3,000 athletes normally take part in the event. Country Boom is postponing their annual festival that was set to take place this July outside of West Salem. Organizers came to the decision after talking with the La Crosse County Health Department officials. Last year, 20 to 25,000 people are estimated to have attended the three-day festival last year. Organizers are planning for the event to return in July of next year, and that is providing opportunity.
We can expand upon some of the planning we've already done for 2020. But then go above and beyond that of making it something extra truly special. You know, you think about even your own home remodel, you know, you get an extra year to plan and get ideas and sponsors and just the whole community comes together of saying, hey, you should have this. Well, before it was like, well, maybe in a year, maybe in 2 years. Well, now we have a whole year to plan.
Refunds will be available starting tomorrow. La Crosse's Youth Outdoor Fest will not be held in 2020. The city's Parks, Recreation, and Forestry Department announced the cancellation this morning. The event provides a hands-on experience for a range of outdoor activities. This would have been the 12th year of the event. Parks and Rec leaders are already planning for the event to return next year. Turning to the latest local coronavirus numbers, nearly 19,900 people have tested positive for COVID-19 in Wisconsin. 291,000 people have tested negative for the virus. 626 people have died and nearly 13,000 people have recovered from the virus. Two new cases are being reported in Eau Claire, Tremplo, and La Crosse counties at this time. In Minnesota, over 26,200 people have tested positive and a little more than 249,000 have tested negative. 1,115 people have died. One new case is being reported in Houston and Winona counties. In the state of Iowa, a little more than 21,000 people have tested positive and over 158,000 people have tested negative. 589 people have died and a little more than 12,400 people have recovered. If you're looking to get tested for COVID-19, you don't have to wait long. La Crosse County Health Department is partnering with the Wisconsin National Guard, the City of La Crosse, and Western Technical College to host a community COVID-19 testing site. The testing is being hosted on Western's campus and runs from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. on Monday, June 8th. Anyone 5 years of age or older who is currently experiencing symptoms related to the virus are eligible for the test at no cost. Drive-through and walk-up options are available, and we have more information on our website at news8000.com. We want to thank you so much for joining us for this coronavirus update, and we hope to see you tonight at 5, 6, and 10. Have a great day.